Hey, good morning, everyone. Happy Wednesday. Robb here for Southwest Florida Television. I am back for part two of my Wednesday morning beach walk at Delnor-Wiggins Pass State Park in North Naples, Florida. An absolutely gorgeous morning here. The fog is burning off. It was pretty foggy when we started earlier this morning, but now it's looking great. The sun is shining bright. The water is looking good. As I was walking out into the water here, there was a school of about 8 snook swimming in front of me. Can see how nice the water is. Getting shallow here. Beautiful though, the reflection's nice and clear. Some little waves now and then, nothing much. Little breeze. Feels like it's coming out of the east. Feels good, that little breeze. Probably gonna get some rain this afternoon. Spotty showers throughout Southwest Florida. There's a cold front coming through. Gonna drop the temperatures. Supposed to be in the 50s, I think, tomorrow morning. We'll see. We'll see if that happens. Look down to the south. The sun reflecting in the water here. Gorgeous. Hit that share button, please. Invite your friends to join us. Have a walk on the beach. As our friend Roy would say, it is a glorious morning. I'm guessing he's making his stump run. Walking up to his tree stump by now. That's his morning routine. Good morning, Jill. Welcome to the Southwest Florida Television Beach family. Wonderful, wonderful group of people here. We are truly like a family, looking out for each other, praying for each other, sharing each other's joys and sorrows. Just a wonderful group here. It's amazing how many people pop on and off here throughout the morning. That's the whole idea. People are like, why are your videos so long? Well, there's a reason why the videos are so long. They really weren't meant to be watched as a video. It's what people do. They sit and turn it on in the background. They watch the replays on YouTube and they just let them roll in the background. Some of our friends tell me while they're working in their office, they got the video rolling in the background. But the whole idea is to just to allow people to have a place to go in the mornings to get together with their friends, make some new friends, and just have the beach as the background. And we have seen some fun things at the beach over the years. Just yesterday, we saw that osprey get rescued. Got tangled up in some fishing line, and the fishermen were able to set it free, thank goodness. We've had some neat dolphin encounters. We've seen some neat marine life, met some cool people out here. Look at that water. We've seen some sad things too over the years, especially with that red tide. Woof. The destruction was terrible. When we're live, you just never know what's going to happen. I've had some interesting things happen just as I was saying my goodbyes. Look at that sky. Definitely cleared up. They said it was going to be partly cloudy this morning. Well, I don't know where those partial clouds are, but they're not here. They're nowhere in sight. Well, not seeing any little baby osprey heads peeping over the nest here. Up in that tree there in the center. And Roy is still plopped down in his chair. The bathing beauty. The bathing beauty of Delnor-Wiggins.
Hey,
how are you doing?
Just about to take my walk.
I was going to say, it's about time. You better start taking your walk.
Yeah.
Okay. I don't know. Move them out. Head them up, move them out.
Yeah.
All right.
Beautiful morning.
Do you see any dolphins?
No.
No dolphins?
A lot of friendly people.
A lot of friendly people? Yeah. Good, good, good.
Yeah, heads out.
Okay. It's going to be another busy morning, I think. So Roy is all good to go. He got his second vaccine on Tuesday. Or Monday. Sorry, Monday. He got his second vaccine on Monday. So he is all set. He went up to the VA up in Cape Coral for his shots. A bit of a drive. But he didn't have to wait very long, so that was a good thing. They kind of expedited the process. The first shot, he had a little pain in his arm. He could feel, he said he had a little pain for a couple days in his arm. Second one, he said didn't bother him. I wonder if Nana's gonna come out here this morning, and she doesn't like coming out when it gets too busy. Loving this water, loving the color, loving the clarity, the color. It's probably gonna all change tomorrow when the wind picks up. But as of now, it is beautiful. It's taken about 3 days for it to clear up. Good morning. Never fails, it clears up, then we get some rough water, turns it up again. Good morning. How are you? Yeah, I am.
Rick Johnson, this is my wife Gina.
Oh, hi, how are you? Nice to meet you.
Visiting from Seattle.
Seattle? Oh, you came a long way. Good morning.
We've been watching your videos for 30 days now.
Oh, awesome.
We're living the videos.
You are. This is the real deal here. Yeah, nothing like the videos, but the video is the best I can do if you're not here.
We appreciate it.
Well, great. Yeah. Thank you. And enjoy. How long are you here for?
We're just here till we were visiting my brother in Tampa. I came down for 4 nights and we'll be heading back up there.
Are you staying in a hotel down here? Or?
Yeah,
the Cove Inn? Oh, that's a nice place. It's old, but it's nice.
Yeah.
Great little breakfast place downstairs.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah, and you had to check out the dock, did
Absolutely.
You? Yeah, the dock restaurant. That's like a legend around here.
Yeah, yeah.
Awesome. Well, enjoy the rest of your stay. All right.
Have a good day.
So cool. Good morning. How are you doing today? Wonderful. Seattle. Rick Johnson from Seattle. That is cool. And his wife. Nice. They were in Tampa, but they had to come down here and check the place out. I don't blame them. I don't blame them. If you make it to Tampa, you better get down here to Naples and see me. No excuses for that. 2.5 hour drive. Morning.
Morning, how are you?
Good.
If anybody watches with regularity, they're gonna think I own no other outfit.
No, that's all right. I wear the same old beach clothes. Oh, you did good today. Some sand dollars.
Yeah.
Nice.
Found a bunch.
Oh yeah, those are good. Those will brighten right up if you just leave them sit out in the sun. Some conchs.
Decent conchs.
It's somebody found a nice. They're not taking it home, but a nice big sea star, a live one. Yeah, about that big. It was a good one.
There's a lady out here earlier that found a live lightning weld. It was big.
Oh,
was
probably, yeah.
Probably 4 or 5 inches.
Yeah.
But still had the...
Yeah. The whatever you call it in there.
Yeah.
The animal. The
right.
Critter.
The muscle. Whatever.
Yeah. There's. You'll find some big horse conchs, too. I found, you know, some shells out here like that.
Really?
But alive. All alive.
Where do you find those usually? I mean...
Usually on the outer edge of the sandbar is where I've seen them.
Okay.
And this guy, he's always taking all the good stuff. Good morning. Taking all the good shells. You got to keep an eye on him. If you see him, don't let him sneak up behind you. Oh, you missed all the excitement yesterday up at the pass. Right after you left, the fisherman snagged an osprey. Yeah, but good morning. But he, Dennis, you know, helped him get the line off him. He got it wrapped around his wing. I don't know if he got hooked or not, but... Right after I saw you, right after you made your pass up there, yeah. I came and walked probably 5 minutes, less than 5 minutes after that. Yeah, the osprey took off and went over to Barefoot Beach. I said, I think he said, the heck with Wiggins, I'm out of here. I have not seen any dolphins, have you?
I
don't know. Have you seen any dolphins?
No, we saw some up at Lover's Key yesterday.
At Lover's Key?
About 2 days ago.
This water is beautiful, but it's supposed to get rough tomorrow. It's like just when it gets beautiful. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, it is incredible. It is so, it's clearer here than down to the south.
Ready for snorkeling again.
It's gorgeous. Ready for some scuba diving.
Oh, yeah.
You got any scuba gear?
No.
Not yet. Go get certified. And. There you go, on your bucket list. Yeah, there's some great places to scuba dive around here.
I know, down the Keys especially.
Oh, yeah.
I'd love to go down there.
That water's beautiful down in the Keys.
We'll see. If I did it all at one time, I'd have to die.
Did you see that umbrella down there? Down in there? Oh, look at all those. What's that, pelicans?
I came in at 4.
Nice umbrella. You need to go check it out down there.
Oh, I got you. Yeah, all right. I'll check that out.
It was very colorful.
I bet you
were. The guys at the bait shop confirmed what I found was a stingray barb.
A stingray barb?
Mm-hmm.
Interesting. Well, now I know something.
Yeah.
I have to remember what that looked like. It kind of looked like a shark tooth with a barb on it.
It did, yeah.
Yeah.
So it was probably a baby. They said the Seminole Indians used to use those for spear tips.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So was that the very end of the...
It was.
The very end of it.
Yeah.
And that was like the last joint or something
in
it?
Yeah.
Wow.
That's the piece that attaches to the body.
Wow.
It's like the spine.
That was neat.
Probably that was once in a lifetime thing.
Yeah. I haven't seen anybody with one of those. Seen them with the teeth from pufferfish. They find those all the
really?
Time. I've would walk right by them.
Yeah.
They're just little square black things.
Huh.
They're real common out. And there's a lot of fossils out here in the water.
Really?
Yeah, if you're into fossils. We had a couple, but because of the COVID, they don't come down from New Jersey right now. But that's all they would do is look for fossils. And,
really?
Man, he would find some neat things. Rocks with old fish, you know, skeletons in them.
Yeah.
And it was cool.
It was cool.
All right.
Have a good one.
Yep. It is getting busy up here. They got two lines out here.
I don't have to worry about it. I can walk under them.
Go under them?
You might have to go around.
I go right under them.
Have you been down here yet today?
Not yet. I went down the other way this morning just to see if there were any crawls yet. Getting close. Yep, it's getting close. They could start coming now. Yeah, it is beautiful. Another busy day. Woohoo, boy. Has everybody been behaving themselves so far, pretty much?
Yeah, just the loudness.
Yeah, well, it goes. Yep. Nobody out of control. Good, good, good. That's what we like to hear. Everybody kind of trying to behave themselves. Oh, how far am I going to go up the beach here? Sadly, that sailboat is still up there. Doesn't look like there's been any changes to it. Hey, thank you for the stars. I appreciate that. As always, thank you. Your financial support is always appreciated and welcome. If you like what you see, I do rely on tips and the stars and the monthly supporters. If you want to send a little thank you, you can find a link to my PayPal in the description of this post if you like what you see here. Very simple to use. Every dollar counts, especially now at the end of the month. I rely on that money to get me over the hump every month, so thank you. I think I bring you just as much joy as the pizza guy, don't I? Come on, these beach walks have to be enjoyable. Can you tip that guy? Pretend I'm the beach pizza guy. That tide is still going out. Getting lower and lower. Good morning. Yep, I see the flags over there on the right blowing. That wind's coming straight out of the east. As soon as I clear the trees here, the wind's gonna pick up. Did you watch that video that I shared yesterday with Barbara Grove? Pretty interesting. She's been carrying that fossil around for quite a while. She knew it was old. She didn't know exactly what it was. She found out yesterday. That was a really nice gentleman, John. I assume he's a retired geologist. He's a geologist, and he told her that thing could be 100 million years old, 200 million years old, who knows? That's old. It's older than me. Pretty cool. Nice little fighting conch shell down here. At least it looks like a nice one. Somebody didn't scarf up yet. Still got a nice little point on it. Wiggins Pass in North Naples, Florida, at the very north end of Delnor-Wiggins Pass State Park. It's the northern boundary of the park. There's John. Get his report. No, I didn't.
I did. I left a pretty good size.
Really?
One, but I also had left probably 2.5 dozen olives on there yesterday.
Really?
Oh, they're all gone.
Well, so whoever got the olives got my moon.
Got your moon. Yes.
Anything today?
Not too much. I just find a few little trolls.
Oh, some scallops.
Yeah, some scallops.
I have not even been racing up here in the morning.
No.
It's just a waste of time.
Yeah, there's just too many people right now, but that's okay. I mean, last week, this week, and next week.
My friend counted yesterday afternoon, 28 people lined up waiting for the boat. And then when the boat came, more just popped up from everywhere.
And
they were fighting to get on the boat. There were so many of them.
Yeah, they were kind of they're just discharging so many people off that tarpon boat yesterday.
Yeah, it was incredible.
But, you know, that's it. It should thin out a little bit. I mean, today's the 31st, so the January through March, the February through March, and the March renters all should be heading north.
Yeah, we got the Easter people. There's a lot of people here just for Easter.
Right.
And they'll be getting out of here.
Last week, this next week, and the week after.
Yep.
Yeah.
And maybe it'll return to normal slowly.
Yeah. Well, then you're going to be completely in charge. I mean,
well, I'm going to share some of that with you.
Well, no.
First
lieutenant's.
You're going to carry some of that burden.
First lieutenant's leaving in about a week.
So, oh, yeah?
Yeah, we're heading back. Probably for that. But
for how long?
Well, I'm going to
be all summer?
Probably gone all summer. Oh. Barb will be popping in and out.
Okay.
So, but you're the...
I'll hold the fort down.
You're the commander.
I'll hold the fort down for you. When are you leaving?
Don't know yet for sure. Kind of got to watch the weather.
A week from Friday on the 9th? We're doing another...
Another breakfast up there.
A week on the 9th.
Highly unlikely we'll still be in town at that point. Because I'm watching the weather. I'm looking for a good three-day window specifically to get through Alabama and Tennessee.
Yep.
So, watching it. But anyways, hey, have a good day.
Yeah.
We'll see you tomorrow morning.
All right.
I'll see you a little cooler tomorrow.
Yeah. Next few days is going to... Yeah. Might even see a little more rain today. Well, some of our friends heading out of here. I don't know.
Yeah, I think we saw one right to the right of that green door. A little closer to him. The tide current has died
Might have been a manatee popped up here. It's pretty far away. There's no way I can zoom into it. It's over on the other side of the channel. It might have been a manatee. Could have just been a little rogue wave. Nice breeze up here. Nice breeze. Good morning.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you doing?
I'm good.
How's the fishing?
Lots of casting, not a lot of action.
Well, that's fishing. You're fishing.
That's right. I'm not catching. They don't call it catching.
Right. It's fishing. Oh,
nice
well.
Nice looking lure, though.
Yeah, nice.
Yeah. Some of Florida's finest. Looks best when it's on its way in, though.
Yeah.
How's today? Good.
Beautiful. Beautiful out here today.
Absolutely.
Nice little breeze.
And outrageous. I was just hearing that one of the lift bags ended up over here.
Oh, really? From
the
that thing?
Yeah.
The outrageous. Very appropriate name for that boat.
Right.
It's outrageous that it's been there this long.
Oh, shoot, we're going out easily a month,
aren't
yeah,
we? Yep, yeah. It's coming up on a month.
Wow.
Well, I've seen snook running up and down the beach.
Well, I have too. I just can't seem to catch them.
Somebody caught one in their cast net around the corner the other day. I'm like,
really?
Yeah, although a 12-incher.
Can I show you the photos of, I was out here fishing.
Of the whale?
No. And I caught a mackerel, and then as soon as I got it to the top of the water, an osprey snagged it, and it now it's on the end of my line, and it's flying off
oh.
with the mackerel on my line.
They got one tangled up in their fishing line yesterday morning,
yeah,
an osprey.
I'm running down the beach, and I cut my line real quick,
uh-huh.
So I started running this way and hand-reeling in the line, and as I got to the corner, the osprey dropped the mackerel right in between a bunch of pellets. And then the pelicans start going crazy.
Oh,
all
no.
you can see is the mackerel. I mean, I didn't know there was a professional photographer behind me.
Oh, wow.
Photographing the whole thing.
Oh, neat.
I'd love to show you these pictures. They're
awesome. Yeah. Nice.
But I mean, literally, the guy was 10 feet behind me the whole way. He's running down the beach after me. Taking
Very cool.
But he sent them all to me.
Well, wasn't it you that told me you saw a whale out here?
Hell no.
Who was it that was telling me about the whale? Because there was a whale spotted out here in the Gulf, a big whale.
No.
Yeah.
Heard about a great white shark being out there.
Yeah, there's
a whale.
There was a whale. It's, I think it was off the coast of Tampa is where they...
Oh, my
word. Yeah. A big whale, not like these little pilot whales that come
run,
through here.
Run.
Yeah.
Some, my goodness.
I mean, things are changing.
Yes, they are.
When we get great whites out here. And,
I know.
And we get lady fishermen.
Yay! I'm sure we'll bump into you a couple hours from now.
You think? I don't know. You never know. How's business?
Good.
Yeah. If you guys need to pack a home before you move, this is who you call. You call Ashley.
Naples Packing.
Naples Packing. She's the only one in town that does a great job. All the other people stink. You call Ashley at Naples Packing. She will have your house packed up in the blink of an eye. She is the best. She is the best. We all hate moving, but not this girl. It's her specialty. Yep. Amen. Amen. All right. See you later. Ashley at Naples Packing. You know, it's sad, but, you know, there's a lot of older moms and dads down here. When they pass away, it's really hard packing up all their belongings. A person like Ashley can come in there and do all that hard work for you. You just kind of sort through the stuff and let her do the packing. I mean, I've watched her pack an entire house in 4 hours. Just unbelievable. She can arrange for the moving, all of it. It's a great service, a great service. And her prices are very reasonable for what she provides. Another little jet ski tour heading out here. The leader up front there. They look like little ducks swimming out into the water. The mama duck up front. There's four little ducklings behind, and then there's two more little ducklings bringing up the rear. Boy, look how steep this embankment is now. Crazy. We have lost a lot of beach here, a lot. Beautiful, that water is gorgeous when the sun comes out. Look at those colors. And here comes all the folks from Tarpon Cove. 1, 2. Let's see how many get off the boat here. Let's see how many get off that boat. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Ten. 11, 12, 13, 14. 15. 16. 17. 18. 19. Oh, thank you. Counting all the people. 20. 21. 22. 23. Holy smokes. 24. 25. 26. 27. Wow. Somebody just delivered a little olive shell to me while we were watching the people get off the boat. That was
Amanda.
Amanda did it. Amanda, that's Amanda. But she always has her pretty little ribbon in her hair.
Thank you. Watch you every time.
I love it. I love it. Well, thank you. Thank you.
I always look to see who the peeps are at the beach.
There you go. Spying on them.
Don and Barbara, I see them, and I'm like, I was just telling them this morning, you're now a superstar on Southwest Television.
He is. He is. I just am amazed at how many people are getting off this boat every time it comes. And it's like chaos when they come to pick them up. They're fighting to get on it.
It will all be over soon.
I know. Another week and it's over.
Yeah.
Then the exodus begins.
Yeah.
Stay off of I-75.
Definitely. I'm going to have a whole beat.
Yep. By the middle of next month. Yep. It's all the locals again.
Absolutely. Great job, Rob.
Hey, thank you, man. Thank you. Thank you.
Great advertising for our local restaurants, too.
Oh, I'm trying to get more people active in there.
I think that's a great idea. Yep. You'll probably be surprised who shows up.
All right. There are so many beautiful people out here. I have met so many friends. Made so many new friends out here. It's just amazing. Everybody's so friendly here at the beach. Yeah, the beach just makes you happy. There's no two ways about it. Look at that sky. Wow. Wow, wow. Some clouds rolling through, starting to roll through the area now. Boy, you made a big pile there.
Yeah, do you see all the shells? Look at this guy. Yeah, look at this.
Well, head down here just a little further. I can make it down to our channel marker down there. No dolphins this morning. I don't know where they're at. They're out there. They're just hiding from me. Playing hard to get. Tide is still creeping out. Still got a little ways before the tide turns. I was watching the pontoon boat making its way back up the river, and it looks like it's fighting the current. There's some clouds starting to pop in here, roll through, which is nice, makes for some beautiful pictures. Good morning. Well, I think I'm going to call it a morning. Thanks for hanging out with me. Thanks for being a friend. Those of you that are supporters, thank you so much for being a supporter. Remember, if you'd like to send a little thank you, a little tip, you can find a link to my PayPal account in the description of this post, and I do appreciate it. Well, hopefully I'll be out here tomorrow. It's all up to the man upstairs. It is just glorious out here today. No other word describes it as well as glorious. Well, you guys stay safe and stay healthy. Hopefully I'll see you tomorrow morning. Hopefully you'll be back. Hopefully you enjoy what I do here. Remember my mission, bringing people together one beach walk at a time. That's what it's all about. Bringing people together. Spread the word. Share the love. Tally-ho, everyone, tally-ho. For Southwest Florida Television, I'm Rob Stan. God bless.